Ooh-wee, Jingle Bob, it's a cold morning. Yes, indeed it is at my house. How about where you are? Yes, cold, cold. Look at all this cold, all the way from New Jersey, moving all the way down south and across to Texas. Very cold, very, very chilly. At my house, it got down to 29 degrees, and it's warming up slowly. Now, you see a little blue over here in Montana? That's not all snow. That's kind of a mixture of rain and snow and ice, kind of all mixed up together. That should be over with by probably lunchtime for you guys today over here in Montana. Everybody else is looking good, and you know what? This cold, it's not going to last. No siree. By this weekend, it's going to be warm again. And according to a lot of the models, it's looking like November is going to be a warm month. This is an article from over at the station of the Euro model. Now, we'll see if this pans out to be true or not, but a lot of the models are saying the November climate outlook is going to be a warm last month of fall expected across the United States. November has arrived. Looking ahead to this month, it should bring mostly warm temperatures and some elevated precipitation in parts of the country. Now, you can see as we move on down, November usually is when we start to see this winter weather take over the country. Now, this means cold temperatures and snow in some regions. In some places, it has snowed already, as we know. Now, the past couple of months have brought some parts of the country their first measurable snowfalls, with a warmer than usual November in the forecast. We may see less snow and more rain than usual across the country for November. Now, it's looking like the models show mostly, if not all of them, of the country will have a warmer temperature for the month of November. Now, as November is usually the transitional month into winter, these uniformly warmer temperatures could give an abnormal introduction to winter weather. Now, most of the country is projected to only just a little above normal. I'm not saying it's going to be springtime and summer, folks, but it should be warmer than usual. And it looks like it can be an indicator of the ever-increasing role of climate change, whatever you want to call it. It's happening, folks, on the temperature forecast. Everyone in the yellow, that's mainly the entire U.S., you should be a little bit warmer than usual for November when you get up into, say, Minnesota, parts of North and South Dakota, moving down to Iowa, Wisconsin, over in parts of New York, Vermont, all the way up to Maine, New Hampshire. You guys are going to be much warmer than usual, as you can see. Now, the coolest spots should be over in this area here of Montana and in portions of Northern California. And then you can see this is the European model that's forecasting this. Now, the northern Midwest looks like it's going to be the warmest, as I've showed you, with the rest of the country, Minnesota, Wisconsin, and parts of the surrounding states, over 1.5 degrees Celsius warmer than average. This part of the country usually gets around 6 to 7 inches of snow in November, but this November may be less this year, as the air will not be as cold for the precipitation for snow to fall. Now, let's move down to parts of the Great Lakes. You are included in this warmer than usual range. This could extend lake effect season as the lakes are able to warm further into the year. In short, looking like lake effect occurs as the warm lakes allow for the extra evaporation and therefore heavy snowfall. So if the lakes, they hold their warm water for longer, we will potentially see more lake effect events this winter. So please be aware of that. And New England, you're looking warmer than usual for this month. and the region may be warmer, as you can see, during the whole month of November than it has in the past years. Now, this could also limit snowfall in New England, as they are usually the target of northeastern systems. Now, I'm not saying you're not going to get some this winter before winter's over. I am strictly talking about the month of November. Now, some higher elevation regions will also be warmer. Parts of the Rocky Mountains will have temperatures elevated by 1 to 2 degrees Celsius. Folks in the surrounding states rely on the Rocky Mountain snowpacks for their water year-round. Now, a warmer start to winter could limit the accumulation of snow in the peaks, and it will be still fairly wet for this month. Look here, right here. Models are showing hope for drought mitigation during November. The central U.S. is forecast to receive some rain, a little more than usual, as you can see, and regions modeled with more rain compared well to regions currently in drought. So you can see right in here. Look at the rain. Look at the rain. We're going to have it in the Florida Panhandle as well as Florida State all over just about. Moving on up the coastlines of North Carolina, South Carolina. Over here, you can see lots and lots of rain. Portions of Texas. I know you guys need it. Moving on across into portions of Louisiana. All of this rain is going to move all the way up to portions of Illinois. And it can reach Wisconsin and parts of Minnesota, also some of California, looking like rain. And it is persistent. It is persistent in these drought conditions where the regions, however, like Louisiana and eastern Texas, you can see up to 30 millimeters of surplus rain. Now, while the Midwest will likely not see as much snow due to the warmer temperatures, they still will receive more precipitation than usual. Models show 10 to 20 millimeters of elevated precipitation for the region, and this will likely fall as more rain than usual. But will the drought conditions help it? I mean, is it going to help the drought conditions? Yes, it will. Yes, it will. So it's looking like for this month of November, we are going to be kind of on the rainy side for a lot of us, but it's going to be much warmer for a lot of us. And then when winter really hits, look out for the lake effect snows. You're probably going to get pounded. So that's what it's looking like for the month of November. Checking out the tropical weather. Yeah, we got tropical weather season until the end of this month, as we know, and we still do have this system out here right now. This is disturbance number one. Now, it's a trough of low pressure. It is producing limited showers and thunderstorm activity while it's moving westward over the Central Caribbean Sea. Now, I've checked everything out, and it does look like environmental conditions could become a little more conducive for some development of this disturbance over the next couple of days before it moves inland over Central America by this weekend. Regardless of development, this system has the potential to produce heavy rains over portions of Central America late this week and into the weekend. 2 days, very small, 20%. 7 days, still on the very small low side, 30%. You guys right over here are going to be affected the most. Say right in these areas here of Honduras, maybe Nicaragua over here, you guys are going to get some heavy rain coming down out of this, so be aware and I'll keep up on it. But everybody else, Jamaica, all you guys up in here, you are looking pretty good with this system right now. Everything's going to be okay. Nothing that you can't withstand if something does come your way at this time. I'll keep my eyes on it and keep you updated. And this morning, as we look at the forecast map for today, this is for today only. You can see, remember I told you, look right up in these areas of Idaho and Montana and some of Washington State right in here. This is mixed precipitation. Little bit of rain, a little bit of ice snow, and you could have some ice accumulation. Now, once again, this should dissipate by around lunchtime for you guys today. Other than that, we've got some rain going on in Northern California, Northern Nevada, you can see over here in Southern Idaho, Oregon, Washington State, and the rest over in Montana. This is all rain, and we've got some that's coming in over here on the coastline of Florida and down around the Keys in this area here, looking like on the opposite side of the country. We know right now everybody's freezing right around these areas here, from Texas all the way up to New Jersey. That's going to change by this weekend. It's going to warm up into the 70s. That's right. But then you go across the country. Right now, we do have this unsettled weather, and it's going to remain across the Pacific Northwest as a few atmospheric rivers move inland over the region. Now, the first batch of precipitation is ongoing right now, and the levels will be rather high with moist snowfall accumulations located across the Yellowstone region, northwest of Montana, and the highest terrain possible across the Cascades and the coastal ranges. And then by tomorrow, Friday night, and the next round, that's when it's going to come in. Locally heavy rain is expected to push inland and create additional chances for maybe even some localized flooding. Now, recent burn scars will be most susceptible to flash flooding near Northwest California and Southwest Oregon. And then we got mostly dry and tranquil conditions through Saturday across the remainder of the United States. And I told you, these warming temperatures are going to lead to widespread highs into the 60s and 70s by Saturday, and they're going to just spread on around and last for a good time. Okay, I'll put it that way. A good amount of time, days. Now, from the Southwest, Central, Southern Plains, Mid-Atlantic, all these places are going to warm up, making for a picture-perfect first weekend of November. Meanwhile, though, we do have some strong northeasterly winds behind a cold front, and that will make for blustery conditions and rough surf across much of the Florida coastline right in here, as we can see. And that's the check of your weather today. Hey, thanks for joining me. I appreciate it so much. And every single thing you guys do for me, I love you all to death. Thank you so much. Please share this information with your friends, your family, and on your social media to help me keep people aware of what might be coming their way and what to expect. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your donations. Thank you for everything you do for me. And thank you for being my friend. I love you all. Have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. Peace, love, and kindness to each of you. Thanks for watching.